tune into the HP Spotlight. I am Bishop E.E. Hunter.
And I'm Apostle Aquila Hunter. And together, we are the Hunters. We hope that you've been enjoying tuning in every week to listen to powerful preaching, teaching, and inspiration. Remember, God is always your source and your resource.
Good morning. Thank you for tuning into the HP Spotlight. I am Bishop E.E. Hunter. And I pray that these songs that we sing today will minister unto you and will bless your life, will encourage and will motivate you. Today, these songs that we're going to sing are some of them songs that I can remember growing up, those old hymns that they used to sing that really blessed my life and really encouraged me. And so we're going to sing them today for you. Yes, sir. Here we go.
The Lord, our rock, Him we have.
grandma she used to come out and say, oh, he's my rock.
He's my rock.
Yes, sir.
Anna Hunter presents the Christian Women Alliance National Convention, taking place on January the 27th, starting at 10 a.m. This year's theme is Kingdom Silent Assassin. This event will take place at the Town Point Club in Norfolk, Virginia. Early registration is $130, which includes valet parking, continental breakfast, and buffet lunch. Our speakers for this year will be Pastor Andrea Hardy.
Came to let somebody know today that God has a plan for your life. God has a purpose in mind for your life. The Lord said, I'm calling my people to strip away their agenda and to get back into the place of finding out what my will is.
Apostle LaQuinla Hunter.
The Bible says on the day of Pentecost, and suddenly it came like a rushing mighty wind, filled the house. God says what he's getting ready to place on us is when we come into a house, not only are we going to be filled, our whole row going to be filled. The wind of God is going to sweep through, and signs, miracles, and wonders are going to be coming. Some of y'all ain't ready. Baby, cancer will not stand a chance. Diabetes will not stand a chance. High blood pressure. Y'all popping pills when God want to deliver you from pain.
And Dr. Yvonne Capehart.
I dare you to press just a little bit further. I hear the Lord say, just a little bit further. You are almost there. You are almost there. Open up your mouth and shout. I came too far to quit.
We will also host our annual Shark Tank, where our Shark Tank judge will be Dr. Pamela Odom. Come out and be empowered by the Word of God. Christian Women Alliance 2024 National Convention, Kingdom Silent Assassins. For more information or to purchase your ticket, visit our website at www.wearecwa.com. We look forward to seeing you there.
Another who sat under that same word that seems like they can't get up and they cannot tunnel through. It is not that God's word is not effective. It is that which has heard it has not taken him for his word. Oh, tell you the reason, I'm getting ready to take him for his word. So in order to understand the word agreement, we would first have to understand what it is to disagree. Because the truth of the matter is, the body of Christ, we have lost a lot of time because we really don't agree. We serve the same God, but we really don't agree. We believe that he's Lord of lords and King of kings and Alpha and Omega, but don't let your church get blessed and the church down the street don't get blessed. Y'all ain't gonna help me. We will soon see how dysfunctional the body of Christ is. Oh, come on now. Everybody seems to be building their own individual kingdom. And as long as individuals are getting their own individual praise reports, people are very happy. But God says, what I want to do in this hour, I want to give a corporate blessing. Oh, tell your neighbor, say, you can't be blessed without me. Matter of fact, I am the secret to your success. Oh, y'all ain't talking to me. I'll look at your neighbor and say, I'm the secret to your success. I'll look at somebody behind you and say, I'm the secret to your success. You hating on me? You rolling your eyes at me? You think I'm talking about you? You're gossiping about me? But you will never get what God has for you without me. According to this scripture. According to this scripture. And so the power of agreement is so strong. Because a house divided against itself cannot stand. Which means, which I saw this morning, there is one half praising in here and there's another half sleep. Which causes problems in the spirit realm. Y'all ain't helping me. You're in a thinking, matter of fact, you're practicing witchcraft. Because God's trying to get through and you are so tight and set. Oh, come on now. Tell your neighbor, say, go ahead and wake up so she don't have to call you out.
We're about to put the witch out.
We're about to get the witch out.
Come on.
control the atmosphere. Because we were ready to break loose, but some of you atmosphere controllers were sitting there like, I'm tired, I'm ready to go. Oh, but somebody said, we getting ready to make the devil mad. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's got, ain't nothing you can do. Can we just support him for 1 minute? Unto you whatsoever. Let's stop right there. God says, don't put any limitations on me. Because we seem to think God can move in one area, but he can't move in the other. God says, I specialize in things that seem impossible. When you shake your head, it's when I push my finger. Oh, somebody ought to praise him right there. You've been shaking your head over your bills, shaking your head over your children, shaking your head over your marriage, and God says, I'm getting ready to move for you, because I specialize in the impossible. Oh, somebody said, if you preach, you can preach back. What does that mean? You yell at me, I yell at you. You shall bind. The word bind means to stop or to tie up.
Yes.
Which means we have the authority to tie the enemy's hands.
Yes. Yes.
You got to learn to say, I bind you. Yes. I tie you up. I stop you in the name of Jesus. Yes. You ain't got time to be crying, complaining about it, and talking of, I bind you. I stop you. I tie you up. Y'all ain't working with me. Y'all ain't working with me. Whatsoever you bind on earth. He says, the minute you bind it up and tie it up, I'm going to honor it in heaven. So literally, heaven claps and says, amen. Oh Lord, y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready. The minute you say, I bind you, the enemy stops right there and heaven claps. Now why is heaven clapping? Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In heaven, he's already bound up. So heaven starts clapping in agreement that you took authority in the earth. Oh, y'all, come on now. Come on now. Come on. Do we got to backtrack? Rewind. Heaven claps. It says, we're surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses.
Yes.
I mean, people who have gone on before us are peeking over the balconies of heaven, saying, I see how it is here. And he can't come to here. Heaven looks like this on earth. And the only way that can happen is you got to bind the enemy. He already defeated him on Calvary. Now we come and execute what he's already done. We bind you. I need you to take a minute and bind him up. Now, what are you binding him over? It's not enough just to bind him and you don't know what he's binding him from. I'm binding him from off my finances. I'm binding him from off my mind. I'm binding him from off of my children. Come on, application of the word. We shouting off of stuff and don't know how to use it. The word don't work unless you know how to use it. We're talking about whatsoever you bound on earth, bind. It shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever you loose means to untie or let go. Which means it is not effective to bind something without loosing something in its place. You tie up poverty, but you never call down prosperity. So you stand at a standstill. Poverty ain't hitting you, but you ain't going nowhere. I'm preaching better than you're responding. You better go shut my higher. You binding everything up, but you ain't loosing nothing. The minute you bind it up, you loose it with prosperity. You loose it with healing. You loose it with breakthrough. You loose it with joy. You loose it with peace. Now I need you to loose up. Now speak something in the atmosphere that you just bound the opposite of what you want to see. Whatsoever you bound, earth shall be bound in heaven. Look at this. Whatsoever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven, which submits to us that God is not going to do anything until we tell him. Oh, y'all ain't ready, y'all. And he says, I made you gods. Okay, y'all ain't ready, y'all ain't ready. Come on, come on, come on, come on. So God talks back to God. Y'all ain't gonna help me. Help, come on, y'all ain't gonna help me. And you start speaking his word. He says, I am my word. And my word will come back forward. I watch over it. Are you ready? Which means if his word is in you, you represent his word. He keeps his eyes on you because he's watching himself. Oh, y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready.
Thank you, Lord.
Then he comes back. Verse 19 again. He says, I want to reassure you. I want to lay this foundation for you so you have an understanding. I'll say unto you again that if two of you shall agree, two equivalent to the sum of one or more, or three. All right. And this hour, God said it ain't gonna take many folks to do. Okay, see y'all, you looking for a big crowd. Let me break it down for you. Jesus had a congregation of 12.
Come on, man.
He ministered to the masses, but his local church was 12. Y'all ain't gonna help me. Y'all ain't gonna help me. Tell your neighbor, say, God, get ready to work it out for me. The last is get ready to be first. He's getting ready to take this little bit and blow my mind. Oh, y'all ain't gonna help me. He's getting ready to multiply. He's getting ready to stretch. He's getting ready to provide. And you know what? Ain't nobody gotta be with me but two folks. Tell your neighbor, say, can I get two? A matter of fact, me and one more. Which means me. If two of you shall agree, what is the word agree? To approve of something, to concur, to have the same opinion about something, and to be on one accord. Sounds like a lot of work, don't it? Especially for church folks.
Talk about it, Apostle.
I can only imagine the color red.
Come on, man.
I don't have no red. Amen. And I sure enough ain't going out to buy no red. I'm tired of all these colors. Okay. I gotta bring it down here.
To purchase your copy of this powerful message, email us at gatmbooking@gmail.com. We thank you for watching the HP Spotlight. If this broadcast has been a blessing to you, we invite you to write us a letter or send a donation. If you're writing a letter, you can send it to P.O. Box 533, Windsor, Virginia 23487. Or you can make a donation via Cash App at $HP Music and Arts. Or via PayPal at hpmusicandarts@gmail.com. or via our website, www.hpmusicandarts.com. Or you can also mail that donation to P.O. Box 533, Windsor, Virginia, 23487. If you're an artist, author, or entrepreneur and would like to be featured on the HP Spotlight, you can also email us at hpmusicandarts@gmail.com. Again, we thank you for tuning in, and we will see you next week.